Within the 2 weeks of our international summer school, we had a big goal. We wanted to build a 4.5 meter high structure from bamboo, which is based on a specific mathematical form. So what we had to learn first was how to bend straight bamboo into mathematical curves.
This sculpture is reaching art, engineering, research, and design. So this is also like a pretty big experimentation.
Our aim was to present our sculpture in connection to the exhibition Plant Fever in the park of Pillnitz Castle. There are strong regulations for restored sites, so we were very excited when we actually received the permission. Of course, this gave us a certain pressure to finish the project in time.
We consulted with a lot of people that actually work in bamboo all the time, and we explained to them this insane plan that we had for this week, and most of them told us that it won't work. Just by taking into account the experiences we're dealing with, the logistics and everything, it was almost an impossible thing to do.
The first week was very intense. We had lectures basically starting from 9 or from 10 until the evening. Lectures connected to material science, biology even. There was a lot of mathematics, theory about curvatures, surfaces, etc.
This sculpture is coming from certain kind of surfaces that are known in mathematics and in classical surface theory.
It's the first time that I learned about the Dini-Fläche surface, also the Kuhn and Bresser surface. It looks elegant in the formula of mass, but also aesthetically pleasing.
They have a lot of nice properties in geometry, but the fun part is that these properties can also be useful for architecture and fabrication. We find a new interpretation of these things in a new field, and I think that's kind of what makes it exciting.
In the first week, we had a very practical part. We divided participants into groups, and they had a task to design an object for a specific location in Dresden and build small-scale models.
Having the hands-on experience, it just brought in so many new problems that we didn't expect to see. We were tasked with putting together a structure based off the Dini surface. And once we did that, we were able to adapt that design to a physical template, put it in a laser cutter, and within 5 minutes, we had all of the pieces and we basically made ourselves our own little jigsaw puzzle. The one that was very successful, it came together perfectly and you could see all the curves.
We had Rafael Ascoli from Blue Temple on the weekend visiting us with small experimentation in bamboo, where we tried to make some small scale models. And thankfully also we could have some free time. So the school was well balanced, wasn't just sitting at the computer.
At some point in the first week, I kind of counted the days and the things that need to happen based on the testing that we were doing. And then I started to kind of be, okay, I think we need to start now. And this is what exactly happened. I spoke with Daniel and I told him I need at least 10 people to work with me now on the sorting and the cutting to lengths of the poles.
Now that we understand the theory behind what we're doing and we can get to the heavy lifting of all these bamboo pieces and really experiencing the actual physical demands that are put on us as we deal with splinters, we deal with cracking. It's exciting, it's kind of terrifying, but I'm really happy to see something slowly and very strongly come to life.
Bad moments is, they are not moments, they were nights and evenings and mornings. The first cuts, for example, were always the worst. The first poles were always the most kind of deformed ones.
I think it's not true if you say you especially enjoy those moments of frustration and you have to improvise. But at some point, those memories of improvising and searching for a different solution are the ones that you remember the most.
There were a lot of instances where I had different ideas coming from different areas and I entrusted them. I was really worried how the splits are going to go in terms of time constraint. And all of a sudden, I saw that they figure out this combination of Masayo and Christian, how to split them in the way that they would split stones in quarries. And I thought it was ingenious, and I was beyond happy because all of a sudden we cut the work hours into almost a half.
As soon as some steps were finished, as I said, the main poles were, for example, prepared, you could see that people are getting more relaxed and happy. So when we cross the lines of small achievements, it's always a moment when everybody's feeling better.
We had the great support from our collaborative partners from the concrete lab. They support us with logistics stuff, and also my colleague Egor did the mixture of the concrete that needed to be poured in the bamboo poles in order to fix the screws for foundations. Also, on the other hand, we were very lucky to have the bamboo experts with us, Rafael Ascoli, but also Vince Matt, who helped a lot in the last days on the construction work, as he's a consultant for the bamboo structures on construction sites all over the world.
It was just a feel-good moment to have someone with that spirit to be around and to feel that we're actually doing something that is somehow approved by people that usually do that.
After 3 long days of hard work, we finally finished our last pole and packed up everything for the transportation to Pillnitz Castle. There we had a beautiful spot in the park where we assembled the sculpture. We arrived on Thursday morning with all our material, and the opening ceremony was planned for Friday evening. This makes 2 days of thrilling uncertainty.
But we need to turn it this very, very slowly.
I think at the moment, since we're not completely finished, it's a mix of exhaustion and also a bit pride. It's still a little part you play in this whole thing, but it's also your project at the end.
They literally dropped the last part of their energy, and we finally managed to finish just before the starting of the ceremony.
In the end, I'm really happy with the results of the summer school because we were able to show how to apply mathematics to engineering and architecture. And of course, we gained a lot of knowledge how to work with bamboo.
We are showing that bamboo is not something terribly exotic, but we can use material from here and we can use the structures which are showing mathematics in a very friendly way.
It's a little bit overwhelming, to be honest. So to see it happening because of this great collection of people I'm working with, is that they are a very high caliber of work. To see something in the end rewarded this amount of effort that was put in, you can't ask for anything more, I think.